students, welcome back in your computer science class. Here we meet again with another new topic, understanding desktop. But for understanding desktop, you should be aware of hardware and software and Microsoft Windows. Children, do you know what are hardware and software and Microsoft Windows? If you know, well and good, but if you don't, today I am going to give you a brief explanation about hardware and software and Microsoft Windows before teaching desktop. Okay, let's begin with hardware. What is hardware? Children, hardware is the collection of all parts of computer which you can touch physically. I'll give you some examples like input and output devices. You can touch monitor. You can touch keyboard, you can touch mouse, right? So all are these hardware. Children, these are hardwares what outside of the computer. There are some hardwares which are assembled inside of the computer like microprocessors, motherboard, RAM memory, right? So these are also hardware because you can touch them. This is all about hardware. Next comes software. What is software? Children, hardware cannot perform any function alone. It needs some instructions. Now, from where it will fetch those instructions? It will have those instructions from software. We can say a software is a set of instructions which is given to the computer to perform a task. Okay, this is called software. Now, software has two types. One is system software, another one is application software. Let's talk about system software first. What is system software? If I say that if your computer doesn't have system software, then your computer cannot run. You cannot operate your computer. This much importance system software has in a computer, right? System software is a software which controls and manages activities of the computer. Okay, so we can say to run a computer, what do we need? System software. Alright, few examples if I'll give you for this. Microsoft Windows, operating systems, right? Operating systems and driver devices. Okay, and Microsoft Windows is an example of operating system. Alright, next comes application software. If you do not have a specific type of application software in your computer, that doesn't mean that you cannot run your computer. This is the major difference between application software and system software. Let's take an example for application software. If you want to paint something, what will you open in computer? Paint software, right? So for doing painting, you will open Paint. But if you don't have Paint software in your laptop, it doesn't mean that you cannot operate your laptop, right? So this is a major difference, that system software is a kind of compulsion for our system to run our system. But whereas on the other side, application software performs a specific type of work in a computer. I gave you an example for that. If you want to do painting, you will open Paint software, right? So this is all about system software and application software. Got it? Here we have completed here. This was a brief explanation about hardware and software. What is hardware? Hardware is the collection of all parts of computer which you can touch. What is software? A set of instructions which is given to a computer to perform a task. Software has two types, system software and application software. System software, system software controls and manage all the activities which are happening in computer, and application software performs a specific type of task. Now next is Microsoft Windows. Microsoft Windows is a GUI based operating system. Okay, now here you can say, ma'am, what is GUI? GUI stands for Graphical User Interface. We will not go into the deep what is GUI. For this, I can explain you only for now that Graphical User Interface is a medium to communicate with a user with a computer system. For this, I'll give you an example. The same example I'll give you. If you want to open Paint software, you will double click on it and it will open, right? If you want to arrange your files, you will simply drag them into a folder. Because of GUI. GUI is the medium to communicate, like whatever commands you are giving to the computer, with the help of whom? With the help of GUI. I think now you have understood. GUI is the medium to communicate the user with the computer system, right? So this is all about GUI. Microsoft is a GUI based operating system. Now we'll understand desktop. Now you can ask, ma'am, why did you tell us hardware and software and Microsoft Windows just because teaching desktop? Because children, desktop is a part of your Windows, right? So to understanding desktop, you should know what is Microsoft Windows and hardware and software. Now we'll see what is desktop. Yes, children, for desktop we can see the first screen which appears on the monitor after loading the window is called desktop. Whenever you open your computer or laptop, after loading the windows, the first thing which will show in your computer, it is called desktop, right? So now what kind of things you can see on desktop? For this, for explaining this, I'll give you a simple example. Most of you must have study table at your home, right? What kind of things you keep there? Pen or pencil box, study timetable and clock. Now why do you keep them on your study table? Because you use them frequently, right? Same as that, on desktop you keep those things which you use frequently, okay? Like if you like painting, so you will keep paint software on desktop. If you like typing, so you will keep WordPad on the desktop, right? So the things which you use frequently, those things you can keep on your desktop. Yes, children, so this is about what you see on desktop. Now we'll discuss the types of things which you see on desktop. I'll tell you what. Desktop contains two things. First, icons. Another one, taskbar. Now, what is icon? Icons are the small pictures which you see on desktop. Like whatever software or whatever folder, whatever file will be there on your desktop, it will show in the form of image. Okay, so this is called icons, a small pictures which you see on desktop. Now, some common icons you can see on desktop are recycle bin and this PC. In some computers, this PC name is my computer, but the things are same. Now, what do you see in this PC? This PC lets us check the content which we have in our CDs, DVDs, hard disk, or some external devices like pen drive. Okay, so this PC, you will double click on this PC to open any icon. You just have to double click on that particular icon, it will get open. Okay, suppose you will have to open this PC, you will double click on that this PC icon and it will get open, right? So where were we? Yes, this PC, it lets us check the content of CDs, DVDs and hard disk and external storage devices like pen drive. This is the work of this PC. Next comes recycle bin. Why do we use recycle bin? Children, when you delete anything from your computer system, no, it doesn't get deleted permanently. It simply goes to recycle bin. Now, if you want to see the deleted file, What will you do? You will simply double click on recycle bin. There you can see the deleted file, and even you can restore your deleted file from there. Okay, so this is the work of recycle bin. So these were some common icons: this PC or my computer and recycle bin. Now we'll talk about types of icon. There are three types of icon, children. First is file icon, then folder icon, then program icon. In file icon, what does it do? In file icon, whatever work you are saving in your computer, it will save as file. Okay, it will save as file, and different type of documents can have different type of icons. Like if you save a Word document, so the icon will be different. If you save a music on desktop, so the music icon will be there, not the Word document icon. Okay, so icon, the image of icons will be different if you are saving the different kind of things on computer. Got it? Next comes folder icons. Folder icons help us to organize the file. Like the files you are saving on computers, you can put them in a single folder to organize. Right? So what does folder icon do? Folder icon is a simply first a collection of files which helps us to organize the files, because you can put all, you can sort all the files in a single folder. Right? Next comes program icon. Program icon is simply an icon of a software. By double clicking on it, you can open that software or you can execute that software. Alright? So these are the icons: file icons, folder icons and program icons. Now we'll discuss taskbar. What is taskbar? Taskbar is the long horizontal box which appears at the bottom of the computer. It has five main parts. What are these? Start button, search box, notification area, peek button, and the last one, middle section. Start button, search box, notification area, peek button, and middle section. We'll discuss them one by one. First is start button. What is it, children? Start button shows or appears at the left corner of taskbar. When you will click on it, a list of options and programs will appear, and it is called start menu. Now what kind of things you can do with the help of start menu? You can open any program, you can search any file or folder, or you can shut down your computer with the help of start button. Next one was, what was that, children? Search box. With the help of search box, you can search anything within milliseconds. Like you will simply, like if I'll give you an example, if you want to open PowerPoint, you will simply type in search box Microsoft PowerPoint, and here it goes. Here you can see on the system Microsoft PowerPoint. By clicking on that, you will reach onto the Microsoft PowerPoint. So this is the work of search box. You can simply typing on that search box, you can open any program. Right? The next thing was notification area. Notification area, it shows or it appears on the right corner of the taskbar. And what is the work? It displays time, date, and some small group icons and tells the status of running program. Like whatever things you are doing on the system, on the computer, it shows the status of those program in the notification area. Right? Next is peek button. Peek button is also merged with notification area at the right corner of the taskbar. And what does it work? Or whatever things you are doing on the system, it minimizes, when you click on peek button, it minimizes all the programs and shows the desktop background. Okay, and the last one is middle section. In middle section, what kind of things you can see? In middle section, children, whatever programs you use frequently, suppose you are using Google Chrome at many times, so at taskbar you can pin that, or it will show you every time on the taskbar. You need not to type in a search box and then go to the Google Chrome. You can simply pin that onto the taskbar. And apart from that, whatever things you are doing, suppose you are typing a note on a WordPad, so that icon of WordPad also will be shown onto the taskbar. So two things which you can see on taskbar in the middle section. First one, things which you use frequently, okay, the icon of them. And the second one, whatever you are doing, the icons of those things as well, but in a underlined manner. Okay, now here we have completed the taskbar. Next is desktop background. Desktop background, children, you all have changed it many times, right? And you like to change it. The picture which you can see on desktop is called wallpaper. Now, children, I know by saying verbally or by explaining only theoretical part, you will not get anything. So, now I am going to show you the practical part of icons and this taskbars. And I'll tell you how to change the desktop background as well. So, the whole thing, the understanding desktop, now I'm going to show you practically how can you do all such things. Okay, children, still after watching the practical part, if you have any doubt, you can ask. Okay? Okay, children, so here I'm going to finish it. Now I'll add the practical clip of desktop. Okay? Have a nice day. Thank you. Alright, children, now I'll tell you the practical part, whatever I have taught you till now about desktop. So this is the desktop which you can see in this video right now. The first screen that appears on the monitor after the Windows operating system is loaded, and it contains two items, icons and taskbar. What are icons, children? All the small pictures which you can see on the desktop, these all are called icons. And the next thing is taskbar. Taskbar is the long horizontal bar at the bottom of the computer screen. Here you can see, right? Start button, search box, notification area. At the bottom of the screen, you can see taskbar. All right, now let's discuss about icons in details. Children, I have told you earlier, right, that different type of file will have different type of icon. See, for example, the Microsoft Word image or icon will be different from the text document icon, from the Google Chrome icon, or from Microsoft Excel icon. Like, every file has its own icon, okay? Next, we shall discuss about some common icons which every desktop has, like this PC and recycle bin. What does this PC do, children? This PC lets us check the content of our CDs, DVDs or drives or external devices. Here you can see practically, right? I can check by simply clicking on anything. I can check what is inside it, right? Now next comes recycle bin. By double clicking on it, you can view the deleted file, or else you can restore your deleted file as well. As I am doing here, see, I'll restore this audio file. Here you can see the option of restore. I'll click on it and it will be restored in my desktop or wherever you saved it earlier, right? Now we'll see types of icon. Children, it has three types: file icon, folder icon and program icon. File icons, whatever we save in a computer, it saves as file. And every type of file will have a different type of icon. Like Microsoft Excel will have its own icon, right? Word document will have its own icon. Text document or notepad will have its own icon, right?
Music will have its own icon. So every file will have its own icon, different from others. Right, now let's discuss about folder icon. What is folder icon? Children, you will collect all the files inside it. All right, it helps to organize the files in folder icon. You can sort your files or manage your files in folder icon. Okay, lastly comes program icons. A program starts on clicking on a program icon. As I have clicked here on Google Chrome, so it will open. Means you can simply open any program by clicking on that icon. Children, this is all about icons. Now we'll discuss about taskbar. What is a taskbar, children? The taskbar is the long horizontal bar at the bottom of the computer screen. Look at the screen of this computer, children. At the bottom, you will find a taskbar containing start menu, search box, notification area, peek button and middle section. Let's begin with start button. When you click on start button, list of options of program will open. As you can see here, it is called start menu. By this, you can shut down your computer. You can open any program, right? See, if I want to open any program like Paint, so what I'll do, I'll search that program or software Paint, then I'll click on it. By double clicking on it, it will get open, right? Okay, now move on to the second one, which is search box. By clicking on search box, you can open any program. See, suppose I want to open PowerPoint. So I'll type here Microsoft PowerPoint. Look, I didn't even type the whole thing and it shows here Microsoft PowerPoint. From here, you can, by clicking on it, you can open it. Thus, we can say we can quickly look for a program or an application on the computer and open it through a search box option. Okay, so this is about search box. Now next is notification area. Children, look at the right corner of the computer screen. Here you may find notification area. It displays time and date and small group of icons. See here. And it shows the status of running programs. Okay. Next comes the fourth point, peek button. What does it do, children? Peek button minimizes all the open programs. Suppose here I have opened Google Chrome, right? So when I'll click on peek button, it will minimize the Google Chrome program and displays the desktop. Okay, so this is the work of peek button and it is also merged with notification area at the right side. Now let's see the last one, middle section of the taskbar. It shows all the frequently used programs and all the open programs on the taskbar. So this is it about taskbar. Now we will learn how to change the desktop background. For that, we'll right click anywhere on the blank area on the desktop. Then we'll click on personalize option. The personalization setting window will open. Okay. All right, let it open first. Then we'll do the further process. Here we go. Here you will find background. And if you are not able to find background here, simply look at the left panel of your window. There you will find a background option. When you will click on it, you can choose the picture which will be shown on the drop down list. See, here I have the background option. So I simply click one of them and now my desktop background has been changed. When I close this window, you will find that my desktop background is different now. See, told you, right? So this is all about what we learned today. We learned about icons, taskbar, and how to change desktop background. Now I'm going to give you a copy work which you will do in a rough copy. Have a look on that.